I will start with today's session. Now, focus of today's session will be we will be preparing ourselves for 10 marks question being asked in university. Now, it is the third session on chapter number one, that is Software Quality Assurance Fundamentals. And in that, we have covered a lot many things in previous classes. Now, in this today's session, we'll majorly focus on the software quality factors and software quality matrix, that is a process matrix, product matrix, and there is one more that is called the in-process matrix. So what is exactly those things? So we'll go into details. Now, basically, when we talk about the quality, as far as quality assurance is concerned, we need to know the important things, that is, what are the benefits of implementing service-oriented architecture. Yesterday, we have gone into detail different functionalities of service-oriented architecture, what all different standards are being specified, that is, whether it is ISO or CMM level or TMM level, that is testing maturity model. So different types of models are being implemented by the industry to check the quality at each and every level. So by implementing this quality assurance, your product and your productivity goes to the extreme level, and you, your company, your organization will be branding your product at a very what was called as a comfortable level. You will be catching more customer, and the level of customer satisfaction will be at the extreme level. So whenever you are implementing quality assurance cell in your organization, you will be highly, you will produce a high quality product, assured. It is because there is some process. If you are following those process very systematically, 100% they produce high quality softwares. And indirectly, the high quality application saves your time and cost. So indirectly, it will be benefit for your organization for the saving your time and the cost. It is also benefit for getting a better reliability. As the customer are satisfied, they are much more flexible. So if you are using Google Meet, you know that Google is paying and has some standards. So it is the best option to use Google Meet whenever we are connected to one another in the session, like webinars, all those things. So reliability is again a major factor, and getting a reliability to its extreme stage is only possible whenever you are implementing the software quality assurance standards. Another more important benefit of you implementing this service-oriented software quality assurance is that it is conducted on no maintenance for long time. So when you are creating a product of excellent quality, when you are creating, when you are creating the product at extreme quality, 100% it will be very much beneficial for the long term. So you will be your product life will be automatically increased because you will be focusing on the quality itself. And indirectly what it will do is that the high quality commercial software increases market share of the company. You have seen lot many applications now in the market working excellently because they are being going for what we call as market shares has been increased. We have seen the app, different applications which are now being used by the people freely. They have downloaded, but just like a WhatsApp you are using, just like a Facebook, because you are not paying anything to them, but they are what we call as they are earning in billions and trillions of rupees. So indirectly, when we talk about the quality assurance, the product which you are creating under that atmosphere or that environment, 100% that will be having some commercial value in the future upcoming market. So that is one more important thing when we go for software quality assurance. It improves the process of creating software. Once you have created, implemented SOA, 100% SQA, 100% whenever you are going, switching to the new product, launching of new product, you will be much more comfortable, and you will be assured that your product will be accepted by the market in at a high level. So that is one more important thing of implementing this SQA. And finally, it improves the quality of the software. So indirectly, if the quality of the software is good, surely the customer satisfaction level will be high, and you will be rated at the high value, and you will be used at the international level also. So that is most important thing whenever the company thinks about SQA. Now there are, we have yesterday we have seen that we will be today's session is focusing on the quality factors, what all factors are required, on what factors it is being checked at each what we call as a terminal of your development and testing. And then after that we'll be entering into the different matrices. There are different formulas been used by the industry for qualifying, for making the quality improvement in the process into the product and into the in process, whatever which is working on. So basically, we talk about there are different models have been implemented by the industry. So software quality factor, it is nothing but some models, some standards you are following. So whenever we talk about software quality factors, there are two things we have to keep in mind. So quality can be categorized in two ways. It is broadly been divided into two types of categories. One that is direct. So the first category is of a factor is those that can be measured directly. So the things which you can measure directly, such as for example a logical error. If your program is having a less number of errors, 100% your quality of your product will be increased. So the things which are measured directly, that comes under one factor. And second factor that is being used, that is being clubbed of number of sub what we call as sub units, and that sub units is been used and it has been checked by your quality assurance cell, and that is nothing but measured, which are measured indirectly. So there is direct measurement and indirect measurement. So direct measurement means what? Number of errors, number of bugs in your application. And indirect factors means what? That measuring to check for the content and the quality control. So there are different quality control perspective aspects on which the product quality is been identified. So you have to keep in mind whenever the quality factors are concerned, one is directly measured and one is indirectly measured. Some just like a tangible and intangible. If you are having money in your pocket, it is somewhere you can measure it. But you are, your portfolio is very big. Not many people you know. If you give, if you are working in the industry, your good faith at the back end will be working very nicely, and your manager will be accepting you because it is not on a salary, but it is on a quality you possess at that designation. So there are two things, one is not directly measurable and another one is indirectly unmeasurable. So you have to keep in mind that the quality is being measured in two different factors. Now as far as the quality of factors are being concerned, there is a person, there is a separate model, there is a classical model which was been invented in 1977 called as a McCall model. Now this McCall model is containing 11 different factors. So we have already seen these are the two major broadly divided factors. But when we talk about this model, that is McCall model, when this model is implemented by the industry, there are 11 different factors that will be used by for the purpose of improvement. Similarly, on the same parameter, different industries are implementing different types of models, factors for quality assurance. That we have seen the number of factors, that is 11 number of factors, have been changed into 12 to 15, depending upon the situation. But different types of models which are being implemented, that is Deutsch and Wills model in 1988, it was been developed. And it contains 12 different types of factors. And well as there is one more factor model is in the market, that is Evans and Markins model, Even and Markins model in 1987. This is the third type model. Now we don't think about what is this Dutch and Wills model and what is this Evans and Markins models. So these two models are basically been invented from this McCall model. So we need to know the information, what is being incorporated into the model which was being created in 1977. The name of the model is McCall model, and it is containing basically 11 factors. Don't think about what is this 12 factors newly invented in 1988 and 15 factors which was implemented in another model in 1987. So we will not focus on this. Your major purpose, intention will be, we'll be talking about the classical model, the name of the classical model which is calculating the software quality factors. It is McCall model. Now this McCall model, all these models do not differ subsequently from McCall model. So if you know the McCall model, surely you will be understanding the different types of model. The McCall factor model provides a practical up-to-date method for classifying software requirements. So it is as per the Pressman's 2000 what it is called as edition, that has defined that McCall model is the only one model on which different types of models are being implemented. And if you implement this McCall factor model, surely it will provide a practical and up-to-date methods for classifying your software requirements. So we need to go into detail about this McCall factors, and there are different types of factors being implemented. So as we have talked, that is McCall factor model is containing 11 different factors, and each factor is most important for us. So we need to know what all factors are being considered by the people, that is McCall, during the implementation. And these factors are nothing but it has been majorly been bifurcated in three different substreams. If you know these three streams, then only you can understand this McCall model in more detail. Now the product operation model is consisting of majorly five different components. So you have to keep in mind the product operation factor is a subpart of this McCall factor model. So this McCall factor model is divided into product operation factor, product revision factor, and product transition factor. So these are the three factors, that is product operation, product revision, and product transition. So in operation model, there are different five factors. One is correctness, reliability, efficiency, integrity, and usability. These are all intangible things. You just have to check the correctness of your application, the reliability of your application, the efficiency, the integrity, and the usability. So these are the basic five factors which comes under the head called as a product operation factor. Another factor, that is product revision. Now you are going for the revision. You have already gone for the operation, and then you are going for the revision for checking whether your product is excellent or not. So there are three different factors which are working under this head called as a product revision factor. That is maintainability, flexibility, and testability. So maintainability, what is it means? We'll go into detail. Flexibility and testability. So these are the three different types of sub factors which are present into product revision factors. And another subtitle that is coming under the MAC factor model is nothing but your product transition model. And this product transition model is that you are moving to the improvement of your product. That is nothing but a portability, reusability, and interoperability. So these are the basic things, terms you need to keep in mind whenever you are doing knowing or working on the quality assurance cells, and you will be implementing this McCall classical model with 11 different factors. So you have to mug up the names of these all factors and its sub factors which are present into this. Now we'll go into detail about what is exactly there in the product operation factor. So in this is the first sub part of a product operation factor, and it, as we have said, that there are different five sub factors which are working under the title called as a product operation software. The first one is correctness, then is reliability, efficiency, integrity, and usability. Now what is exactly the meaning of correctness is you have to keep in mind. Now it's nothing but this requirement deals with the correctness of the output of the software they include. Now these are the basically different parameters are being checked whenever you go for the correctness. The first one is output mission. So you have to work on the output, what is the purpose of your application. So whether it has been fulfilled correctly or not. So you are creating an application of accessing or allowing multiple users to access your e-commerce website. So it should be that the multiple users should be interacted with the system, and there should not be a bug whenever the different users are using your application. So there should be a correctness. Second one, the required accuracy of the output that can be negatively affected by the inaccurate data or inaccurate calculations. So you have to go for the corrections, and you have to check whether the data or whether whatever the calculation you are doing, it is at the correct parameter, following the correctness of your mathematical operation or your data accessing phenomena. So you have to keep in mind it should be a correct. It should not be that you are logging with your Gmail with your own Gmail ID and you are getting the mails of another Gmail. It is not possible. So authenticity is most important for the purpose of correctness. Now, second one is the completeness of the output information. If you are expecting something in the output, you should get 100% same for parameters in an output. It should not be affecting incomplete data. So the complete data with the correct information should be in front of you. Next one, to the up to dateness of the information. So it should not be that you are providing information, you are clicking something and you are getting information at of something. So it should be very specific as far as the time is concerned between the events and the response of the software time. So if you are clicking your current information, it should display the current information only. So you are accessing a mail, Gmail or anything mail ID. You always see that at the top of your mail, it is always a recent mail. You cannot see the mail whenever you have created some 2-3 years before. You are getting the mail of the current at the pop-up, at the top situation, at the top level. And you are getting the old mails at the bottom. So it's the same thing is that there is nothing but the correctness, the data, the accurateness and the calculation, everything that resides into the name called as the correctness. So this is one factor which is most important whenever we talk about the product operation software quality factors. Now another factor is reliability. This is the most important thing when we talk about any application, it should be reliable. Reliability requirement deals with the service failure. So if you reliable means what, if I'm accessing some website and you find that website is not working or it is under maintenance, it becomes very hectic for the user. So whenever you are creating an application, you see that it deals with the service and there should not be a failure whenever the application is running, whether it is a Windows application or whether it is a web application. Your software should be ready, available as soon as the user is want to interact with the system. So that is called as reliability. Reliability only depends on the product quality and the commitment given to the customer. If the commitment, if you have failed with the commitment of not providing the service on time, 100% the reliability of that product will be reduced and the customer flow will be automatically will be reduced. It will be grading your application to the lowest level. So that is most important thing that you have to think about the reliability. Now the efficiency, now the era has changed. We have converted from Mbps into Gbps. Now we are accessing the data not in MB, now it is day, we are accessing the data in GBs. So there is no issues as far as you are accessing the information. But the thing is that whenever you are talking about efficiency, the hardware resources need to perform the different functions. So you know that if you are using your mobile or you are using a personal computer or a laptop, the hardware responses are most important. So your hardware should support your applications very efficiently. It should not be that your hardware is not connected to your application is not working properly. Efficiency is measured in the forms of the data, the process, the capability, the storage capacity and the data communication capability. So all these three factors. Processing capabilities are being calculated in the form of megahertz, that is MSZ. Your operating system is basically focusing on processing capabilities. So your network, your hardware components need to be configured in a very systematic way. Your application should be supporting to that. Whether it is your whichever operating system it is there, you are using an old operating system or a new operating system, your application should be processing with high efficiency, with high capability, with some megahertz of data need to be moving into your operating system kernel, and there are different components of operating system, so it should be capable to access and to execute its working. Now second important thing is that the storage capacity. The storage capacity is again most important. Now it is giving from MB to GB. So data is moving from MB into GB. You have seen whenever you click your any picture, and if it takes more time to save in your mobile, automatically the reliability of your mobile, automatically you think that the product, your mobile is getting declined, your application which is clicking your photo is getting declined. So automatically the customer will be switching to new application or a new mobile. So that should not happen as far as efficiency is concerned. And second important thing, that is data communication. If you are interacting with some website through your mobile or through your PC, the communication between your mobile, your device and your server should be that, it should be very much faster, that is it should be very much efficient for giving an information on time. These are the major factors when we talk about in megahertz or in MBs or in Mbps. So speed is important, size is important, and the frequency of processing is all most important. So these are the three factors which are very in the keyword code as efficiency. Now, integrity, this factor deals with the software system security. So integrity is nothing but you are meeting authentic users to use this application. So unauthorized users should not be allowed. It should be declined at the immediate stage. It should be a group of people who are doing some malpractices, and they will be interacting indirectly with your application. So that type of interaction of hackers should not be happen with your application. That there is nothing but you have to go for the key word called as integrity. So authenticity of a user is most important when we go for the factor of product operations. And last one of this is the fifth factor of product operations software, that is usability. Now usability requirement deals with the staff resource needed to train a new employee and to operate the software system. So the application you are creating, it should be very much simple. You can't predict that there should be a training for the user who are using your application. So the application you are creating, it should be very simple up to the date, and it should be very simple. You cannot see the menu bar at the bottom of your application. You see all the menus which are always that file, then you are doing some editing or you are viewing an application. That type of menu bar is always at the top. You never see menu bar at the bottom. Because that is the simplicity, the eyes always look at the top position, top left. We read always from the top left portion and we'll end up with the bottom right position. So you should put your major event elements at the top, and that is nothing but the usability. So usability is nothing but you have to be giving an application to the people who are not trained or who are not been trained to use that application, but still the people will be interacting with the system and using more efficiently. So that is nothing but the usability is concerned. Now this is about the five factors we have seen into the product operation software quality factors, and these are the most important as far as the operation of software is concerned. Now we'll switch to the next. That is, whenever your product is being created, now it need to go for some revision. Revision means what? You have to do some maintenance, you have to do something testing at the runtime. Because only creating application and then stopping your team to do some maintenance is very tough. So you have to do your maintenance. If your application is being maintained by a specific person, then only the usability of the product increases. यू टेक एन एग्जाम्पल, अगर हमने घर में कुछ घर पे जब हम रहते हैं तो डेली आप उसकी साफ सफाई करते हैं, तो पर्पज इज दैट आप उसमें रहना चाहते हैं, तो व्हाट इज मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट इज क्लीनलीनेस, बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है हमारे लिए, उसके मेंटेन होना चाहिए. अगर हम कुछ गली यूज कर रहे हैं तो उसका सेल अगर खराब हुआ तो हमें वो नया सेल परचेस करके उसके अंदर डालना चाहिए. छोटी छोटी चीजों के ऊपर हमें फोकस करना चाहिए, तब जाके अच्छा लगता है. सेम फैक्टर्स whether it you have after these factors, that is product revision factors, come after implementing your application. Now you have implemented your application in the market, people are using, thousands of people are using your application. Now you, what you have to do? Now these are the three things which are being recommended by McCall model in this revision quality factors. These are nothing but maintainability, flexibility, and nothing but last one, that is a testability. So what is maintainability? So as we have said that whenever an application is created, it need to go somewhere failure, some bugs or some errors might occur at the runtime. So you cannot say that any product which is launched in the market is 100%, whether it is being created by Google or any other company of CMM level 5. The product cannot assure that it will be running efficiently, because you are using different platforms, you are using different operating system, you are using different browsers. So compatibility plays very important role. So many people, if you talk about India, Indian people majorly focus on using operating system like Windows, and there are different flavors of Windows. You might be using XP or Windows 7 or Windows 10. Any that is Vista also. Some people might be using previous version of Windows, that is Windows 2000 also. So you cannot expect the people to use recent versions of operating system. Same way, when we talk about Western culture, the Western people focus on Mac operating system. Then the people might be using open source operating system like Linux and Unix, Ubuntu operating system. So maintainability, the application whenever it is implemented by the people, it should be compatible and it should be used by the people, and you have to do maintenance at the frequent level. If your product is maintained, then only user will be satisfied with your product. So that is nothing but a maintainability. Now flexibility. Now this factor deals with the capability and efforts required to support adaptive maintenance activities. So flexibility is nothing but you are adapting some new techniques, new technologies at the runtime, and this factor will be improving your performance. It will be what we call as a support for the perfective maintenance. So new applications, new technologies are implemented at the runtime, and what it will do is that the look and feel of your application will be changed, the processing speed of your application will be changed, everything will be changed, and that is nothing but a flexibility. You have to create an application which are flexible. Once it is being created, you have to make it more flexible for the customer in the recent days and in the recent months also. So that is nothing but a flexibility. And last one, testability. The testability requirement deals with the testing of the software system, though it has been implemented. Whenever an application has been installed, we think that it has been tested and finally it has been dispatched to the customer. But no, you have to do testing frequently. After implementing those applications, you have to do frequent testing. And if you find any bug or any problem, you have to add those patches and you have to make your product more usable to the customer in a more efficient way. So these are the three factors which are most important whenever we are talking about the Mac model under the review quality controls. So these are the things we have to improve. Now we move to the second last part of this. These are the three major sub factors that is called as a transition. Now you have created an application, and after creating you have done some specific factors, that is you have gone for flexibility and what we call as testing continuously. Now what you have to do is you have to upgrade your application after some frequent time. Some may go for upgradation in 15 days, or some people may think of upgrading the software after 1 month. Some may think of upgrading the product after 1 year. Now same thing what we see, that operating system, that Microsoft has created different flavors of operating system. Windows XP was there, still they have created Windows 7, still they have gone for Windows 8, Windows 10. Now why these people are doing this? Because the basic purpose of any operating system is that it should be used by the people. It should be used by the people. And if you are saying that your product has been used by the people, then what is the need for upgradation? If you are upgraded, if you have gone for the improvement of your application, surely your customer portfolio, that is the list of customers, will be increasing. They will be thinking their application is working efficiently and new features are being implemented. Now this is one more important thing that you have to keep after that implementation of a product, that is a transition of software. Now how this transition can be done? There are three different ways, that is called as a portability, reusability and interoperability. Now portability is the same thing what we see, that there are different hardware, there are different operating systems, there are different browsers being used by the people, and you have to make your application more portable. And you, for checking the portability, there are different browsers. I think the count has gone for 50 to 60 new browsers being used by the people. We just know the name, that is Edge or Chrome or Firefox or Opera. But there are different types of browsers being used by the people. If you are using mobile, there are different browsers. If you are using any tab, there are different browsers being supported by the different applications. So you have to create an application that is portable, can be executed on any different platform, on any different hardware also. So that thing you have to keep in mind after implementing your application, that is you have to focus on portability. Then the factor called as a reusability. the modules you have created during the development of your software need to go for reusing. It should not be that you are creating a new application, you are adding something new into your application, and you are not using the previous programming concept or previous models. You have to go for using, reusing the different old modules, that is the legacy application modules need to be used whenever you are going for upgradation. So it should not happen that you are moving one step ahead and you are losing the previous modules that you have created. So you have to maintain the old modules also, and you need to create new models, and you have to see that the both the modules are integrated in a more efficient way. So that is called as a reusability. Reusability of what? Reusability of the old modules and implementation of new modules with integration with the old modules. So that things you have to keep in mind whenever you talk about the reusability. Now the thing is that interoperability. Now what is the meaning of interoperability is that interoperability requirement focus on creating interfaces with other software system. Now your application should be communicating your information, your data with other applications also. It should not happen that you are creating an application that will not interact with other any other applications. So you have to make it interoperable. We have seen lot many websites that are not working on different browsers. So what is the basic problem is that it is not supporting. Why it is not supporting? Because this is not interoperable. Interoperability means what? You have to create such a type of application. You have to do very meticulous testing of this application. And you have to use, you have to create an interface where two different applications will be interacting with one another. So these were the basic 11 factors you have to keep in mind under the three different titles concerned with this Mac call classical models of quality factors. So this what we see have will wind up with this. Now basically we'll now switch into the second part, that is software quality matrix, and we will stop today with only the description of product matrix. So today we'll go into detail only about the product matrix models, because this is the huge model we need to know. So this quality software quality matrices. Now matrices means what? Now you are doing something what we call as a matrices. Matrices means what? You are going into detail about how to implement this factors that we have talked in Mac model. So we have only talked theoretically how this Mac model, what all things need, factors need to be used whenever we are using, talking about some quality. So these are the matrices that will be calculating your productivity of your application. Now it is basically been divided into three different categories. One is product matrices, one is process matrices, and finally that is project matrices. Now if you talk about the product matrices will be focusing only on the product you have created as a whole. So it will describe the characteristics of the product, such as size, the complexity, the design feature, the performance, and the quality levels of your product. Now second factor, matrices, is nothing but your process. Now the internal processing, what is going on in the application is, now here we are focusing on some characteristics such as to improve the development and to maintain the activity of the software. So you, for the purpose of doing something more development and for the purpose of maintenance, you will be focusing on the process matrices. And finally, for the project matrices, this matrices describe the project characteristics and execution. For example, include a number of software developers, the staffing pattern, the life cycle view you have used for the purpose of implementing for creating a software, the cost of the software, the schedule, how much time it will require for the development of the project, and the productivity after production, how many users will be using that application. So product matrices, process matrices, and finally as a project. Project is somewhat different, product is somewhat different. Product is only a small component that will be used by the people, and project will be integration of different aspects in your application. And as a whole project, what all things are required, whether it is staff, whether it is a cost, whether it is a schedule, how much time it required for the implementation. These are the major three matrices you have to keep in mind as far as software quality matrices are concerned. One is product, second one is process, and third one is project. Now today's session will be focusing only on the product matrices. Now here we have seen, whenever we talk about the quality matrices, the software quality matrices are the subset of software matrices that focus on the quality aspect of the product, process, and project, as we have seen. These are more closely associated with process and product matrices with its project matrices. So when we talk about this, there are different matrices which are working under the head of software quality matrices. One is product quality matrices, in process matrices, and maintenance quality matrices. Now we talked into detail about the product matrices. Now product matrices is been divided further into three different that we have seen that the matrices have been divided in product matrices, in process quality matrices and maintenance quality matrices. Now university people are expecting only product quality matrices and maintenance quality matrices. But now still we'll be going into detail about the in-process quality matrices also. So how this in-process will be going for its quality improvement. So product quality matrices. Now what exactly we have to check whenever we are talking about the quality of any product. So what we have to check is that we have to check these four different categories. What is mean time to failure? Now we are talking not about the execution, we'll be talking about the failures. We have to manipulate, we have to check how much the failure application will be going into failure or how much time the product will require for the purpose of execution. So first, quality matrices of product is mean time to fail. So what time will require? What is the mean time? Mean is nothing but you are doing what you call as average. You are calculating the average time required for the application to get fail. Second one is defect density. How much defect you have identified in your application after it has been implemented. Then customer problems. What all problems are being faced by the customer whenever you are using that application, whenever the product is being used by the customers. And last one, the satisfaction level, that is customer satisfaction for that specific product. Now we'll go into detail about these four different components which are used for under the title called as product quality matrices. What is exactly the mean time of failure? Now it is the time between failure. This matrices is mostly used with safety critical system such as the airline traffic control system, or we majorly see this is implemented that is how much time it required for the failure. So this is implemented in the airline trafficking. You see that railway and air, you will never see that they have been conflicted or there is accident. Rarely there is an accident in airline. It is due to the failure of an airline. It is not due to the accident that happens frequently we see on a road. So this is nothing but the mean time. How much time a application will require for getting into failure situation. So you have to calculate that is a mean time to failure. Then only you can specify that your product is more efficient. Same way it has been used just like in a real life example, weapons. Whenever you are using any ready-made what you call as a product for implementing your weapons. So that situation you should know at what situation your application will be failed. So this is the real life example. Same scenario you have to think whenever you are creating an application. So you have to calculate the mean time of the failure. The second one is defect density. Now you have to check, you have to quantify the number of lines. You have to express the size of a line or a code or a function point. And you have to identify the unit of defects at each point it has been generated at whenever it has been commercialized. Whenever your software has been used by different people, you have to count the number of defects and the density. Daily, the product is creating an error, or at every moment the product is creating an error. You have to qualify, you have to quantify the number, and that need to be put under the header called as a defect density. Now customer problems, you see that whenever the customer are using an application, there are many problems being faced by the customers. Whatever application you have tested in your environment, you cannot assure that the same application will be used in the same passion by the people who are not trained. Your customer are not trained to use the application in the way you have created. He may click at any moment, at any situation, he may stop the application at any moment. So it should recover from that application. It should not be happen that you have stopped that application directly and it is not working again and again. Same thing happens with the operating system. Whenever we are switching the application just like operating system directly, we are not using shutdown button. You see that your operating system internally is going for recovery. Now what is that recovery? It is that it is again recovering the files which are being stopped directly whenever you are going for execution. You have implemented, you have real life mein dekha honga, jab bhi aap koi use kar rahe application, jaise word use kar rahe, powerpoint use kar rahe, ya phir koi browser use kar rahe, agar light beech mein switch off ho jati hai PC ki, to aap agar apne fir se usko restart karte aur browser ko open karte, to aap dekhenge ki aapko restore karne ke liye puchta hai, yani agar aap jo link ke click karke padh rahe the, jo aap use kar rahe the, wo automatically aapke samne aa jayenge. Same with operating system. ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम शट डाउन ऑटोमेटिकली अगर आपने डायरेक्टली स्विच ऑफ कर दिया और नेक्स्ट टाइम आप चालू कर देंगे आपको फिर से बूट करने के लिए वो पूछेगा एंड ऑटोमेटिकली इंटरनली इट विल बी रिकवरिंग योर सिस्टम फ्रॉम द डेडलॉक सिचुएशन दैट इज नथिंग बट दीज आर द कस्टम प्रॉब्लम्स बीइंग फेस्ड बाय द कस्टमर योर एप्लीकेशन शुड प्रोवाइड सैटिस्फैक्शन टू योर कस्टमर नाउ हाउ दिस सैटिस्फैक्शन इज बीन कैलकुलेटेड यू हैव टू चेक द कस्टमर सैटिस्फैक्शन अंडर द फाइव डिफरेंट पैरामीटर्स वेदर द कस्टमर इज वेरी मच satisfied or he is neutral, he is not being concerned about your application or he don't like your application by seeing dislike or very dislike, dissatisfied. So you have to calculate, you have to check your customer satisfaction level at frequent point and that point you have to put it into a matrices and that will be nothing but your product quality matrices.
So are you clear with this one?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So these are theoretical things we have to go into detail. Now I will mail you the. You have to prepare a short note on this points what we have covered today. I will provide you a short detail. But this question might be asked for 10 marks. That is the previous question. There might be a question on your. Surely there will be two questions, that is what are the quality factors and what is the quality matrices. So 5 to 10 marks question may be asked on these two different points. The notes will be provided in the format of a Word file after completing my lectures. Another lecture of third year will be completed and then after that I will be providing you the theory of these two things. You have to prepare a notes on these two points and you should be ready for these two factors. That is quality factor and quality matrices and probably the question paper might be containing the question on this dono mein se ek pe question to 100% expected hai in university examination. So okay, so we'll stop.